Good morning again. Thank you all so much for being here today. We're having a great day of panelists that many of you got to see. And this afternoon, throughout the day, we're having some different programs for some of the Region 1 Gear Up kids. My name is Lisa Woodward. I'm a registered nurse, and I'm also Vice President of Nursing Education here at Doctors Hospital at Renaissance. In just a minute, Israel Rocha, our CEO, is going to come up and do the official welcome. But I wanted to take just a minute to tell you what brought us here today, sort of a prequel, like The Hobbit before Lord of the Rings. In November, I was fortunate enough to be asked to be on a delegation up to Houston that was put together by Congressman Hinojosa. He led this team and asked me to be a part of it, and it was to look at different models that were out there that coupled industry and education, because what we need is to have educated individuals brought together with businesses and educated to be able to produce a well-rounded workforce. Little did I know that that day would bring us here to where we are now. To tell you the truth, I was extremely excited about this opportunity, but I also was very, very nervous. Here I was with Congressman Hinojosa, a U.S. congressman, with all of these leaders from the Valley, Assistant Superintendent Mr. Garcia, Dr. Cancino from Region 1, and so many more. And Congressman Hinojosa asked us to all go around and ask and tell him why were we here? What was our purpose? And I could have been quiet, but I said, no, I have to make sure that I take this opportunity. I'm sitting here at this table, and I need to make sure that my voice is heard. So I said, hello, my name is Lisa Woodward, and I'm representing Doctors Hospital at Renaissance. And we believe that we can graduate associate degree nurses at the same time that they graduate from high school. Now, Cindy Rivas and I had been working on this before that, but it wasn't polished and it wasn't ready. And here I was announcing this to a group of people that were going, really? You can do this? So we came back and we got together, PSJA, Doctors Hospital, South Texas College, Region 1, and Med High. And we said, how are we going to make this happen? And how are we going to make this happen now? We can't wait. We need nurses to care for our sick in our community. We need to have good careers for our youth as they get out of high school, not later on. So we worked hard and we worked diligently as a group and collaborated, and we're making this happen now. Yes. As a registered nurse, as a mother of three children who in some way will be impacted by this program, and as a member of this great community, I am delighted, I'm proud, and I'm very honored that I have been a part of this innovative project. And now I'd like to introduce Israel Rocha, our CEO.
Good morning, everybody. Today, I'm very excited to be here. And before we get started, I want to thank some of our partners who helped make today possible, whether through the program design, innovation, or just community support. Because one of the things that I've learned early on, and one of the things that we're here today, is to celebrate public-private partnerships, that they can produce great ideas and great innovation. And that starts always by having the support and the partnership with your community. So I'd like to thank a few community leaders who are with us today. Congressman Ruben Hinojosa, for your always dedicated support to our hospital. We want to thank you so much. Everybody welcome Congressman Hinojosa. Mayor San Juanita Sanchez from the city of San Juan, who's always been very helpful to our hospital and to our community. Mayor Richard Garcia of our home city here in Edinburg, Texas. There we go. City Council Member Richard Molina from the city of Edinburg. Also joining us. Dr. Shirley Reed from South Texas College, a strong supporter and contributor to our programs, and a great partner in helping today's innovation and programs, and whose leadership has helped inspire some of the partnerships that we're having here today, is Dr. Daniel King from PSJA. Another innovative leader in education, also Dr. Marla Guerra from South Texas ISD. PSJA school board member Bobby Rodriguez, also joining us today. Thank you. PSJA school board member Lupe Rodriguez, also joining us today. Thank you so much. PSJA school board member Jesse Vela, also with us today. Thank you. Thank you for your support in helping to make today's partnership possible. Also, Gary Gerwitz, South Texas Community College Board of Trustees. And Paul Rodriguez, South Texas College Board of Trustees, also with us here today. And Laurie Nahosa, Hidalgo County District Clerk, also joining us today. You know, the great thing that, and I talked a little bit earlier for some of the students that were here in the meeting before, I always talk about the power of innovation and creation and how they can take you almost anywhere that you want to go. Today is an exciting day because we're here to celebrate what happens when those things come to work and when they come into practice. This started almost a little over a year ago. We were sitting in a room, and as Lisa talked about, we were talking about the nursing shortage here in Hidalgo County. And we were looking at all the problems that we're going to have in helping staff nurses and how quickly we could get them. Unfortunately, one of the things that we also have, you've heard about the generation and retiring, we're losing a lot of well-trained nurses who have special credentials in how to treat specialty patients in our intensive care units or our critical care at our neonatal level, emergency room nurses, nurses that need that specialized training. And we started looking, how are we going to meet the needs of the future? How are we going to meet the needs of the staff? And how do we get people trained? And how do we do it faster? Why are we having to leave the community in the Rio Grande Valley when we have such talented students like you have here today? What can we do as a hospital to make sure that we have our community here, that we invest in our children, and that we meet the needs of our patients? And it was a discussion that went on for a while. And my request, not knowing the limits and creativity of my own staff, I said, why don't we have a program where we can at least have students, we create a lifelong learning pathway where people can, we will invest and partner with the students, and over time, they will graduate high school with a certified nurse assistance program, and then we will put them into a residency program. They can get their bachelor's, they can get their associates or bachelor's, go all the way to their master's. And so the goal that I told them was, let's do that program, let's create the pipeline. And it was an idea. Then shortly later, we went and we met with Dr. King on a wonderful program that we're having with him on community and schools and how we could help bring clinics to the school district to make sure that students wouldn't have to go further when they need a medical assistance or for their employees, and how hospitals can partner with communities. And he liked the idea, and he also challenged us back. And he said, I love the idea. I love the clinics. I love the program, but I want you to do something more. I not only want you to care for our patients when they're sick, I mean for our students when they're sick, I want you to care for them when they're in school. So I want you to create a pathway, an innovative education program that gets our students involved and makes sure that they graduate. So those things came together, and then our wonderful, talented staff in the Nursing Education Department, under the direction of Dr. Hernandez, who helped make this project happen here in our community. He's our Chief Compliance Officer and also helps our Nursing Education Department. And Lisa Woodward, our Vice President for Nursing Education, and Cynthia Rivas, who is our Vice President for Professional Development. They came together and they came back and they said, you were thinking small. Certified nursing assistance program, not going to happen. When they graduate high school for the first time in the country, we've designed a program for you that is going to make sure they have an associate's degree in nursing, and they're going to be able to have a registered nurse license graduating from high school. That was really exciting to me. I'd never heard it. When they said it was the first time in the country, it really helped change the course of what we were thinking. And that community public partnership and that creation, that innovation, is really what we're here about at Doctors Hospital Renaissance. How when we say that we're a community hospital, we're a community partner, and that through public-private partnerships, we can change the Rio Grande Valley and hopefully change the future of America and the country on how we educate individuals. Sometimes people think we say them as punchlines. I think today you can see that when you put innovation, you put talent, hard work, and creativity of community partners from around our region, we can help change the direction of education in the country. And we're very excited that that's what today means. Today, we really are starting a new page in the history of how nurses can be trained in the United States. We're starting an innovative program that for the first time in the country, and the students in this room will be able to compete for programs where they will graduate from high school with an associate's degree in nursing. And it doesn't stop there. You can go on, and Doctors Hospital Renaissance is willing to work with you. They're putting you through a residency program, which would be available to you, and which would help pay for your program and your pathway to get a bachelor's in nursing, and then continue into a nursing fellowship and be able to move forward and all the way up to where you can get your doctorate in nursing. And we would be your partner in that success. And so students, in the time that it normally takes to get a bachelor's, would be able to get a master's in nursing, and then shortly thereafter get a doctorate in nursing, and give us those nurses that we need to take care of our community. And a solution that we help design ourselves here in the Rio Grande Valley. And so I think what it shows is that here in the Valley, we have the talent. Shortly a while ago, we said that the Rio Grande Valley wanted to be the pathway for the future of medicine to the Rio Grande Valley, not only here in the Valley, but to the country. We wanted to be the front door to scientific discovery and research. Today is really one of the first steps that we're taking to help change that course of direction and show the Rio Grande Valley that it's not merely just words, but that we are working diligently with our community together to make things happen that others only imagine. And so today is so exciting for that one reason, that we're helping to change the direction, and we couldn't have done it. And it's not just Doctors Hospital Renaissance. It's Doctors Hospital Renaissance. It's the communities of Pharr, San Juan, and Alamo, PSJA, South Texas College, Med High School, South Texas ISD, Region One Education Center, and a host of other talented individuals who have come together to make things happen. But most of all, the final ingredient to make this partnership work are the students in this room. And we're so excited to be seeing you. I think that in the future, the students in this room that go through this program will help change medicine in the future. And I think that's why we're all here, is to celebrate you, even in the start of this program. So we're very excited to go forward. We want to thank everyone who's helped make this happen. And as always, I want to thank everyone in our hospital, all our 4,000 employees, our board of directors. I could go on and on, but unfortunately, with 4,000 people and 700 members on our staff and everyone else, all of them help ignite innovation here in Doctors Hospital Renaissance. And I think this is just one of many new innovations to come. And so we do want you to know that we have a partner, we're here to work with you in success, and that at Doctors Hospital Renaissance, innovation in medicine really does mean something. It means that we can collectively help change our destiny, help chart better futures, help care for our community, and help care for every student in our community. So with that, I want to introduce a quick video that shows you a little bit about the program that we're launching here today.
As Vice President of Nursing Education at Doctors Hospital at Renaissance, as well as a nurse myself, we recognize that there is a great shortage of nurses, not only here in the Valley, but also nationwide.
We all know, and it's a proven fact, that the medical profession in the Valley is in need, particularly of nurses.
We had a need for nurses, and we had a need for them to help our patients today. I'm very excited today to be here on behalf of Doctors Hospital Renaissance, on the hallmark of an innovative partnership that has turned challenges in our community into an innovative program that will lead tomorrow's future. What we wanted to do was to be able to make sure that students were engaged early on the careers that were available in the healthcare industry. That solution involved working with community partners. Community partners like South Texas Community College, Region One Education Service Center, PSJA ISD, and South Texas ISD, largely in their Med High program.
This process starts at the middle school level. It takes the students through high school, through college, and all the way to a job, employment, a secure opportunity these students are going to have for the rest of their lives.
We will actually have high school students taking a college level associate degree nursing program. By the time they graduate from high school, they will be ready to sit for their national licensure exam and to be employed as registered nurses in our community. That's why we're part of this partnership.
Graduating from high school with an associate's nursing degree will be a game changer for our students, our community, and the healthcare workforce in the Rio Grande Valley. This will serve as a model for the rest of the country. This is the Renaissance Way.
We are elated at being part of a partnership, first of all, because partnerships allow the participating entities to utilize their resources and support each other. We've worked very closely with SDC and DHR, And we find that they've done great things and doing great work. So it's very much an honor to be a part of this collaborative.
This is an exciting opportunity to collaborate with the private sector and with our community college partners, South Texas College and Doctors Hospital of Renaissance, working together in a public-private partnership to meet the needs of our students, meet the needs of the hospital, and help our local economy as well.
Doctors Hospital Renaissance welcomes this opportunity to be involved in this model that's unique, that bridges the gap between clinical practice and academia. The great thing about this collaboration is that the Renaissance nurse is committed to working with these high school students to create the best nurse possible so that we can care for our community.
Our community is going to benefit by having well-prepared nurses to accommodate the growing need for nurses and other allied health professionals in this area.
And that is why it's so important. The lives of hundreds of students are going to be impacted. Their lives are going to be improved when they secure a process that is going to take them through their education all the way to a job. Their lives are going to be better. The lives of our community members are going to be improved. The lives of the whole region are going to be benefited by this project. This is really outstanding. I hope the rest of the state of Texas is looking at what is happening in this project, because this is worthy of being imitated by many.
I think this innovative program is exciting, and it's going to change the Rio Grande Valley in South Texas, and then will soon change the nation as the program becomes a role model for excellence across the country. I think that it is a key moment, not only for the Rio Grande Valley, but for nursing education in general, what it will mean for the future of our students. People have asked how you can make change happen. I think these four partners coming together is changing in action. And so we're very excited and honored, every one of our partners and each one of the students who will be participating in the program. Next, I'm very honored and happy to introduce one of actually my former bosses. He was one of the person who hired me out of college and helped launch my training in professional career. So I'm very honored to welcome Congressman Hinojosa. But before we bring him out here, wanted to let you know that Congressman Hinojosa has been a great leader in education. Since he went to Congress, he wanted to be the change agent to make education more available and more accessible for students, and to make sure that every student in the Rio Grande Valley had the opportunity to pursue the education endeavors of their dreams. And he has dedicated his entire career doing that. He has done two things. He's done a few things, many more than I can say, but two things that I know in particular. One, when Congressman Hinojosa came to Congress, there was a program, and it was a program that funded all Hispanic-serving institutions around the country. It helps fund here, University of Texas Pan American. Across the country, that entire program had $10 million a year to help institutions that helped Hispanic-serving communities, like UT Pan American, soon to become UTRGV. In his tenure in Congress over the last 20 years, he's taken it from $10 million to $2 billion, which is a huge feat for what has been able to change education and the opportunity for the future. Through his success and what he has done, he has also been recognized as a STEM field hero. That's science, technology, engineering, and mathematics for students in education. He was recognized by the Hispanic Heritage Foundation. He's been recognized by President Clinton and President Obama as one of the foremost education leaders across America. And this year becomes one of the most senior members in Congress with a rank of 77 out of 435 members of Congress. He is now also a senior leader when his voice is heard and pushes for an advocacy and an agenda the whole country actually has to listen as a ranking member of the education community. So we're very honored to have him as our congressman here in the Rio Grande Valley. Please help welcome Congressman Hinojosa.
Israel, thank you for that very kind and very generous introduction. I'm honored to be here this morning. And when I gave them the welcome at about 9 o'clock, I saw approximately 350 students and about 75 parents, all here eager to learn about this new potential opportunity that is going to be available to our students in the Rio Grande Valley. But let me say that what we're doing is not easy, because there is no other program like it in the whole country. This is going to be the role model. This is going to be the pilot program that is going to be presented to the Secretary of Education, Arne Duncan, to show him that in this area of the Rio Grande Valley, we can be innovative, we can think out of the box, and we can come up with a program that is going to have one very important result, and that is to provide good paying jobs in allied health. If you get into this program, I know that many of you are gear up students, 7th, 8th, 9th grade, and if you have blind faith in what I am going to say in about 2 or 3 minutes, I think that you will be on a road to being able to get a good paying job when you graduate from high school, because you'll have a dual program that gives you a high school diploma and an associate degree, a community college degree that is going to be a great, great paper to be able to get those good paying jobs that I mentioned to you. It's an honor for me to join you for this exciting announcement, and I'd like to begin by congratulating all the great leaders who made possible this College for All conference. It reminds me of January the 8th and 9th of 1998, when President Bill Clinton came to the Rio Grande Valley as a sitting president, second term, and you need to know that the last sitting president we had was President Eisenhower in 1953. To have a 45-year gap of no sitting president coming to Hidalgo County, you can see why we were so excited. But what I saw when he spoke at the Tom Landry High School football stadium to 22,000 people was a big, big canvas that was right behind him on the podium. And on that big canvas, the words "Education for All" was the message. And that was what his speech was about to the 22,000 people listening to his remarks. Today, many years later, the message is "College for All." So you can see that in those 18 years that we have come a long ways. We are improving and getting our students to be college ready when they graduate. And we've taken the high school graduation rate from what used to be 50 to 60% 20 years ago, and it's now over 80%. And I say that that couldn't happen without the state and federal investment in education that has occurred here in the Rio Grande Valley. I want to say that the partnership that you are going to hear about between PSJA, South Texas College, Region One Education Service Center, and Doctors Hospital at Renaissance will no doubt become one of the most beneficial collaborations in the Rio Grande Valley, and we will address what President Obama said to us as members of the Education Committee. That is, you have to do more with less, because we have such a big national debt that they're cutting and cutting and cutting the expenses and the expenditures. And so we have come up with a program that, in my opinion, is going to be a model for many, many other states. This dual enrollment pilot program will create career opportunities for many of our high school students in the field of nursing. Our medical community and our residents will benefit greatly from the advanced education training and experience that await our students. I understand that this new dual enrollment nursing program will be the very first in the country to offer high school students the associate's degree in nursing upon high school graduation. Importantly, though, students will be able to complete clinical rotations at Doctors Renaissance Hospital while their state-of-the-art healthcare academy is being built at PSJA and will be ready in just a few months. In a speech this week, on Monday, Secretary of Education Arne Duncan noted that while high school graduation stands at 80% nationally, our schools must do more to close achievement gaps and improve high school graduation, particularly for Latino and African American students. In closing, I want to say that I'm delighted to inform superintendents here, school board members, and administrators that this week I had the pleasure as ranking member of the Education Committee to be able to learn that we are going to be negotiating, as soon as I get back, the reauthorization of elementary and secondary education and doing away with No Child Left Behind. According to the leadership of our committee, both Republican and Democrats, it was agreed that by March, we should be able to bring it to the committee for a markup, meaning for passage voting on this new program, and then going to the House of Representatives. The same thing will be going on parallel track in the US Senate, and we are of the opinion that they will be able to pass it in the Senate within 30 days after we pass it in the House of Representatives. So that's first. But following right behind it is the reauthorization of higher education. And we expect that that will be approximately 2 to 3 months behind elementary and secondary education reauthorization. And that also will be very meaningful because we are going to be making changes that will now be applicable in the year 2015 and forward. So ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to welcome Dr. Daniel King from PSJA, a gentleman who has come to Washington to testify before our committee on education 3 different times and has been honored in Washington by the Secretary of Education and President Obama 3 other times. Please give him a big round of applause.
Thank you very much. This is a very exciting day, certainly for PSJ, really for the Valley, and for everyone involved in this partnership. What we're doing today is really a game changer. And we're taking on a challenge that we have here in the Valley, really a number of challenges, and taking them on together through a partnership. And that's what it takes, is coming together and working together to solve our problems. And the challenges that we're taking on, one is a shortage of nurses and other healthcare professionals, which currently exists and which is going to grow larger with the new medical school and the growth in the different healthcare fields. We're taking on the challenge of the economy, having a better prepared workforce. And we're taking on the challenge that our young people have of needing good jobs, good careers, good career pathway opportunities. And this is really an extension of a dream that we've had in PSJA for a while and we've been building on. And that's really kind of early college for all, connecting all of our students to higher education pathways, to post-secondary education while they're still in high school. This semester, we have over 3,000 of our high school students that are taking college courses while they're in high school. Last year, over 130 of our high school students received their associate degree by the time they graduated from high school, and another 300 received certificates in different fields. This year, those numbers are expected to approximately double and will continue growing as we go along. This program, and it was interesting as Lisa was talking, to see that in the private sector and in the public sector, we often have our needs and our dreams and our visions are aligned, but it's a matter of coming and sitting down and talking about how we can work together, because one side in isolation cannot solve the problem. It's working together. So last spring, when we began to talk, Doctors Hospital approached us about a partnership on a health clinic to serve the students of the community. And as we talked about where to locate that, we shared with them our vision that we're going to take the old PSJA High School campus that was kind of famous in the 60s and 70s and 80s for the Oso Dome and kind of the round buildings, the auditorium, the gym, and so forth. But we're going to be taking that campus that will be vacated this spring by the middle school, Itzegeta Middle School, that's currently there. And we're going to be turning that entire campus, we're going to be remodeling that campus into different academies, different early college academies, half-day academies, where students will be bused from our different high schools and we'll have different career areas. And so we were showing them that where we were proposing for the clinic would be in the middle of a kind of a health occupations academy where young people, and what we asked them is, can we do more than the clinic? Can we partner together and prepare young people? For years, I've been hearing about the nursing shortage in the valley. For years, I've been telling our young people, take all the math and science you can, get prepared. The jobs are there. For years, I've been frustrated that at the end of the day, the shortage is still there. And as we talk with different partners, it's a very complex problem because you need more nurses with master's degrees to teach the courses. You need more clinical rotations at the hospital. This needs to be worked on by multiple partners. So as we began to talk about this, for several years we've been talking in PSJA about the idea of having an associate degree of nursing. We already graduate students with associate degrees in engineering and physics and biology and chemistry in many different areas. So why not in nursing? The challenge is the slots, the capability, the clinical rotations, as well, of course, the rigor of the curriculum. So as we kind of presented this vision to people at Doctors Hospital Renaissance, it was interesting because there were people there with the same vision. And so the two came together and aligned, and we're very grateful to these partners, to Doctors Hospital, to South Texas College that has been a very willing partner in scaling, and that they themselves are leading the way in dual enrollment in early college all around Hidalgo and Starr counties. And very grateful to Region One for their support, to South Texas ISD for agreeing to partner and share facilities as needed and any other way to share resources. But this very exciting opportunity for our young people, and I want to clearly mention that the nursing program is just really a small piece. And so this nursing program is going to be in the middle of a whole section of a campus where young people will be working on all different kinds of medical areas, getting their certifications, their degrees, and so forth. And in PSJA, our focus is to connect all of our students to college, help them be ready for college, help them to complete college. And what we tell our young people is start now, and this nursing program is a perfect example of that. Start college now while you're in high school. Complete early. So we want them to complete some level early, a certificate, an associate degree, a couple of years of college. Complete early and then go far. So I love the vision here of stacking, of going on. You lock in your associate degree, then you can get, you're young, you'll be 18, have your associate degree. It's easy from there then to go on and finish up your bachelor's degree, your master's degree, go on to medical school, get your PhD. We want our young people to be the leaders of our community. It's great that people come from all over the country and all over the world to find a good living here. But what's even more important is that we provide for our own young people, that we provide for our own young people the opportunity to connect. The Valley's an exciting area, everything from SpaceX, the medical field, everything going on. We need our young people to be the leaders and to have the opportunity to have the great education, to have these great careers, and to be the leaders of the community. The great thing about this is it's a homegrown solution. I want to thank all of our partners. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. King. And now I'd like to introduce to you South Texas College President Reed.
Thank you so much. Good morning, everyone. It may be a little cold and cloudy and gray outside, but boy, is it sunny and warm and exciting in here. This partnership is going to be revolutionary for our community. It's going to be revolutionary for how we prepare professional registered nurses. We see it transforming the quality of life for our families, where our students will have access to really good paying jobs. And we expect you to select this program, not just for a good paying job, but because you truly care about people and you're dedicated to being a professional nurse. It's going to be transformative. This isn't really new for South Texas College. We have established ourselves as a national leader in delivering dual enrollment programs. No one has ever attempted nursing, but we have very successfully delivered programs in engineering, medical sciences, computer technology, criminal justice. As a matter of fact, we have 13,000 students at South Texas College who are taking high school courses and college courses at the same time and proving to the rest of the state and the country that our students can be successful. They truly can complete high school and college at the same time. Absolutely. We have the best students right here in our valley. Now, I do not want to underestimate the challenge this is going to present for all of us. This is perhaps the most academically challenging program that South Texas College offers. Students are going to have to be absolutely dedicated and committed to keep up with the academic rigor of this program. And students, I can say to you, we select the very best students to get into our nursing program, and we have to turn large, large numbers of students away. You're going to have to be almost a straight-A student. You're going to have to take very challenging classes. You're going to have to spend time in the hospitals. You're going to have to give up a lot of social life that you may not appreciate giving up. But when you're done, at the end of 2 years, you will be able to take the licensure exam. You will be a registered nurse, and you will have just a marvelous professional career, a meaningful career before you. But you're going to have to work, and we are going to hold you to the very highest of expectations. You will be dealing with lives, loved ones, and so you have to be absolutely the very, very best. This is a pilot. We want to see if it works. We're optimistic that we're going to be able to make it work, but it's going to take the commitment and the dedication of all partners, not just South Texas College, PSJA, Region One, Med High, and Doctors Hospital Renaissance. So let's have a shout out. Can we make this happen? Can you complete 2 years of college while you're in high school? Can you pass your licensure exam? And are you going to be a great Renaissance nurse? Yes, we sure can. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for our speakers. In a minute, we're going to have everybody come and sign. But all of you have heard and you've been inspired. You've heard about all the potential things that you can do, all the potential that lies ahead of you in the future. But I've always believed that seeing is believing. So for the students from PSJA, I want you to see what your future can be and should be like by looking at the alumni. Here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance, we are very honored to have so many PSJA graduates and the senior leadership team at here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance. So with the PSJA alumni, alumni here with us please stand real quickly for introduction? Wonderful. And I would like to introduce them, so please stay standing so the students can see that it is possible with hard work and determination. Dr. Ambrosio Hernandez is a graduate of PSJA, and he is our pediatric surgeon. Dr. Lisa Trevino is our head of clinical research and development and a PhD in a very fancy thing that I'm forgetting at the moment, genetics and biochemistry, I think. So there you go, very close enough. And then you have Dr. Martin Garza, our new chief of staff for Doctors Hospital Renaissance, a medical doctor in pediatrics. You have Mario Lascano, who is a part of our associate administrator here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance. You have Laura Disk, who is a master in nursing and is our vice president for surgical and procedural services here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance. And then, of course, Elisa Alvarado is hiding somewhere. She is from South Texas ISD and a PSJA native, and she is our PhD in nursing education department. And then also, we have, of course, our nurse for our ICU area, Ms. Nora Medina, who helps our intensive care unit and someone that you definitely want to know and work hard and is one of our advanced nurses here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance. We are very, very, very honored. And so I want you all to see and to know that here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance, we are committed to your future and we're committing to make great things happen. So we will look forward to welcoming you as also a staff member here at Doctors Hospital Renaissance, but most importantly as a nurse, a doctor, or any healthcare provider who will help care for and change the lives of countless patients that you will serve. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll invite the guests to come sign and memorialize today's agreement to please come out and join us on the stage. Well, thank you, everybody. That concludes our presentation. Thank you for joining us, and we look forward to working with you in the future. Thank you so much.